Life rafts are crucial maritime safety equipment designed to save lives in emergency situations at sea. Inflatable life rafts are a means of ensuring the safety of sailors, providing a means of evacuation in the event of emergencies on board a ship. In this video, we'll explore the key features, types, and importance of life rafts to ensure you're well prepared for any dangerous situations on board a vessel. Before we start, please like this video and subscribe to my channel, it will greatly help its development. Inflatable life rafts are visibly stored on board a vessel in fiberglass containers. Life raft must be designed to withstand exposure at sea for 30 days under all weather conditions and should be capable of being dropped into the water from a height of 18 meters, and all its equipment should function satisfactorily after such a drop. The specific locations of the life rafts on board a vessel are indicated in the ship's fire plan. Typically, life rafts are positioned close to the muster stations on both the port and starboard sides of the ship. According to SOLAS regulations, there must be one or more inflatable or rigid life rafts on each side of the ship, with a combined capacity sufficient to accommodate the total number of persons on board. On bulk carriers, the life rafts on at least one side of the ship shall be served by launching appliances. Cargo ships where the horizontal distance from the extreme end of the stem or stern of the ship to the nearest end of the closest survival craft is more than 100 meters shall carry a life raft stowed as far forward of aft, or one as far forward and another as far aft, as is reasonable and practicable. This life rafts may be securely fastened so as to permit manual release and not required to be equipped with hydrostatic release unit. This is a typical inflatable life raft on board a vessel. We will discuss the hydrostatic release unit, painter, weak link, cradle, marking of the life raft, information card, lashing straps, and a detailed description of the attached certificate. One important thing to keep in mind is that life rafts should be securely attached to the vessels to avoid any accidental opening or being lost in rough weather and similar situations. Lashing strap, it is permanently attached to the cradles on one side and connected to the hydrostatic release unit by a pelican hook on the other. This allows for the life raft to be released and manually activated by placing it in the water and pulling on the painter line. But at the same time, they should have the capability to be set free automatically in case of an emergency, and this is made possible with a hydrostatic release unit. When submerged, the hydrostatic release unit is designed to activate automatically, releasing life rafts from sinking vessels. The raft release hook is connected by the H20 strong rope to the strong point. The Liferaft's painter system ensures a connection between the ship and life raft, preventing the life raft from being dragged under by the sinking ship when released. The raft's painter line is affixed to the hydrostatic release unit weak link connector using a shackle. At depths ranging from 1.5 to 4 meters beneath the water's surface, water pressure exerts force on a membrane within the H20 unit. This action triggers a spring-loaded blade that swiftly severs the robust rope. Consequently, the raft becomes detached from its cradle. As it ascends toward the surface, the raft's painter line extends out of its storage container. Upon reaching its maximum length, the raft inflates, bursting out of its housing. The inflation of the raft generates increased buoyancy, causing the painter line to exert sufficient force to break the H20 weak link, securing it to the anchor point. The inflating raft is then free to rise to the surface, ready for survivors to board. When installed, the hydrostatic release unit must feature a prominently displayed expiration date. The expiration date should be set at 2 years from the month of installation, unless an alternative duration is specified on the primary label. The printed label surrounding the HRU provides details for 12 calendar months and 4 years. In accordance with the specified expiration date on the primary label, carefully remove the appropriate sections for the month and year ahead of the installation date using a sharp-edged tool. Each HMAR H20 unit possesses a unique serial number and a manufacturing date engraved on the top surface. Information card. This is a plastic container that contains waterproof paper, which you need to fill out every time you change your life raft on board. Right after installing life rafts on board, you should fill in the name of your vessel, call sign, ship's IMO number, and flag state on the inside. As per SOLAS, provision shall be made for marking each life raft with the name and port of registry of the ship to which it is to be fitted, in such a form that the ship identification can be changed at any time without opening the container. The certificate consists a lot of important information for us. Maximum stowage height, in this case it's 36 meters. As we remember before, SOLAS requirements indicate that life rafts should be capable of being dropped into the water from a height of 18 meters. The life raft must have a painter with a length of at least 10 meters plus the distance to the waterline in the lightest condition or 15 meters, whichever is greater. Here is 50 meters, more than enough. Also indicated the maximum number of people allowed for boarding the life raft. It also indicates the type of equipment inside, either SOLAS A or B pack. SOLAS A pack rafts are designed for longer voyages and more challenging conditions, while B pack rafts are suitable for vessels operating in relatively safer and closer to shore areas. The difference is that not all the items specified in the list of life raft equipment are necessary for a SOLAS B pack. Additionally, here indicated the last and next service date for our life raft on board. After each service, you will receive a special certificate for each of your life rafts, which proves that your life rafts are in good serviceable condition. In the next video, we will discuss the emergency equipment of life raft, special construction requirements, and a lot of other interesting and important things. Thanks for watching.